Happy Halloween, Bloom Trojans. This is the Thursday show. Coming up on today's edition of BloomScene, a sneak preview of Show Choir. I'm your host, Marcus Everhart. On activities, we have Edgar Zerati. And on sports, we have Batman. It is Thursday, October 26, 2023, and you're watching BloomScene. Now for our top story. As you know, we had a great Spirit Week. Today, let's take a look at Spirit Day in the Pep Assembly. Stay tuned to BloomScene for news about our homecoming king and queen. This Friday, October 27th, all students will be celebrated at lunch for their dedication to reducing tardies during the first quarter of the school year. Please continue to arrive to school, all classes on time, and focus on academics during the school day so that we can continue to celebrate the success. Great job, Bloom Trojans. Let's read a book, have an adventure together. Select one of the four books using the links in your English teacher's Google Classroom. We will have fun activities as we eat and discuss our books. Maze Runner, Children of Blood and Bone, Born a Crime, or I'm Not Your Perfect Mexican Doctor for our choices for the first all-school read. That's it for announcements. Let's go with Edgar with activities.
Thanks, Marcus. This Friday, October 27th, the District 206 Band and Choir will hold their combined fall concert at Bloom Trail from 6 to 9 p.m. Tickets can be purchased through Eventbrite. There is a link two in the description of the episode today on YouTube. Want to get an idea on how much work our band and choir students put in? Alex Cervantes produced this story about our show choir.
Well, what comes with the day of teaching choir for me is, first, I have to start off with a lot of energy. I have a lot of energetic students. We do a lot of singing as well as dancing in our class, so I have to make sure that my energy level is on 1,000 when I come into the choir room. During our vocal warm-ups, we do those every day, and that is to increase our range and our vocal agility. And then immediately following that, we do a lot of sight reading so that we can get the students ready to read music and knowing the notes, as well as basic music reading, which is quarter notes, half notes, eighth notes. And then immediately following that, we do rhythm examples because it's important to be able to know your rhythms when you're reading music. And then we roll right into our vocals. So whatever it is that we're working on song-wise, and I like to mix it up. Currently, we are practicing for Parent University as well as our football game. We're going to go out and energize the audience during a halftime game, and we're also preparing for our fall concert.
You can see this show choir and the rest of our district musical group this Friday. You don't want to miss the concert. The Scholastic Bowl team will have their first competition on Wednesday, November 1st at Thornridge. We will meet in Mr. Cook's room at 3:11, right after school. The bus will leave at 3:30. You can't get on the bus without a permission slip. That is it for activities. Now let's go to Edric with sports.
Thanks, Edgar. As we reported yesterday, the boys varsity football team ended their season with a win against Thornton in our homecoming game this past Saturday. The football team ended with a record of 4-3 overall and 3-3 in conference. Congratulations to the new coach and the football players for a good season. We will have highlights from this homecoming football game on tomorrow's show. The boys varsity soccer team defeated Andrew in the sectional final yesterday with a score of 4-1, led by MVP Jonathan Magana. We face Stag in the next round this Saturday. Good luck, boys. We are proud of you. That's it for sports. Let's take it back to Marcus.
That's BloomScene. Teachers, email your announcements to Mr. Cook. We'll see you here again.
Batman.